looking forward to the film.
Absolutely, yeah. Enjoy the cinema. We're a big sort of a cinema going family, so we go quite a lot to different films, all sorts of films. So this one should be pretty good, yeah.
Of course, these little blue characters have been a big part of our lives for decades now. Why do you think the Smurfs have endured so much? What's their magic?
They don't seem to get old, do they? I remember watching them when I was a kid, and that is a fair few years ago. So they've either got good plastic surgeons or they just don't grow old. It's magic. I don't know what it is.
I think a little bit of Smurf magic. Now, did you have a favourite Smurf when you were growing up? Is there one you were particularly fond of?
No, I think Papa Smurf was the one that was always in charge, wasn't he? He seemed to be the boss man. So he's possibly the one. He's the one I remember the most of all, if I'm really honest. Well, Smurfette, yes, obviously, yes. Well, I was only a young kid, so I didn't like women at that time, you know, and yeah, you know. But it might have changed now. I'll see what she looked like when I get in there. Might be walking out with her rather than a wife.
When you're not watching the Smurfs, what are you up to at the moment?
Still doing motivational speaking all around the world. I still own a professional motorcycle team. We're just getting ready for the World Endurance, one of the rounds in Oschensleben in Germany. So, yeah, still pretty busy with the speaking and also motorbikes.
People find out you're a motivational speaker and they ask you for your one golden bit of advice. What do you normally give them?
Whew, an hour's presentation. and then an invoice.